Let's do the electrical work since I'm actually gonna be getting macroalgae in here. Time to organize this because I need to get everything up and running, which everything works, but it's just a jumble of wires right now. So let's organize that, do a little wire management and see what it looks like. I'll take some before and after pics so that you guys can revel in either how well I did or how poorly I did. I decided to go to Lowe's because I never seem to have the right screw sizes when I'm installing the controllers and stuff. I'm always just like scrounging and finding stuff. So I think I'll just buy a few different boxes and different sizes of these self-drilling ones just so I have them for the future. I mean, guys, check this out. I mean, I feel like an idiot. Like, how many years I've been doing this? I didn't know they sold these tops that you can totally open. I've been drilling holes like some kind of Stone Age caveman when I could have just gotten for $2 or $2.50 a nice lid. I'm gonna use some of these and maybe exchange out some old ones too, because this is nice. Deal with this another day because I haven't finished yet with this project. Actually, I haven't even started with this project, so let's go work on this.
The angle is not the best. Better.
Nothing special, but the wires are gone. No wires down here. I was able to put in the 5-gallon bucket with this cool new top, which I can't believe I just discovered. That's so awesome. For the UV sterilizer, I just tucked the wires up here and I used all those Velcro straps just to Velcro the line along the top here. And then over here, I made a mistake and I didn't put this in the right spot, but I'm not gonna redo it. It works just fine. We only have two controllers, the Reef Octopus here and the MaxSpec Gyre controller there. I went ahead and labeled everything. This is one of those fancy Wi-Fi strips that I like. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Wi-Fi outlets on top and 5 non-Wi-Fi outlets just always on. And I went ahead and programmed those onto my phone, set up the chiller running, gonna set it 73, which means it'll go 73 to 74 degrees. And everything is ready to go. I'm talking with Tyler at Inland Reef tomorrow so that we can get the first shipment of macro soon. Okay, I want to show you this. It's currently, 6:33, and the temperature here where I live is 102. This just arrived, and this is from BensNems and Tyler at Inland Reef, and they sent me the first package of macroalgae, but the problem was is it sat all day, and this isn't their fault. They sent it overnight. They sent it with an ice pack. I opened up the ice pack, and I put my thermometer in, and the ice pack was 91 degrees. So I took the thermometer and went over here to the actual macroalgae, and I put it in the bag, and the macroalgae was also 91 degrees. But this is the Gracilaria, I think. It's red, there's no apparent die-off. Even though it was 91, I'm just soaking it. I'm just gonna float it in the seahorse tank. You know, I'm gonna do that for at least a couple hours. And then I forget what he called this, the codium, I think it is, the codium. It's green. I don't see any fuzziness on it, which he said is a good sign, but we're just gonna soak it. And then I think what I'm gonna do is I'm not gonna install any of it tonight. I'm just gonna get out one of my like plastic, what do you call it, the little breeder basket that I hang on the side and plop them in there after rinsing them out. And then we'll check back in tomorrow to see how they look, pull out any death and disease that happens. But these two species evidently are really hardy. So hopefully they'll survive the night.
Hey guys, sorry, it's super late everybody. I've been soaking these for a couple of hours. I have my wife holding, you see the huge mess on my desk. Oh, here it is, okay. I want to test the temperature. I tested them earlier, remember, and it was 92 degrees. This should be close to 73 now. 73.8, okay. So I talked to Tyler from Inland Reef today, and he said, you know, he's asked me, does it look white? So, no, you know, so I would think they're okay. But he said, just don't mix the water. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to rinse them out real quick. I have some fresh water right over here next to me. And I'm just going to put them in a basket tonight in the tank and then check them tomorrow to see if there's any die-off. But, I mean, looking at these...
These actually look really good. I mean, look at that.
Super clean. So I think we're going to be okay. So let's move them over here. They smell... They don't smell great, but that's probably some die-off. And then here's the... I forget what he called this. He says it's supposed to be a little bit fuzzy. It seems a little fuzzy. I don't see any die-off, though, so I think we're going to be okay. But I mean, just look over here. Look how nasty the water is. It's just super yellow. I'm just going to just a gentle rinse. And then follow me, Dana. Probably won't be able to see it very well. That's okay.
Okay, here it is. I don't know if you're still not going to be able to see it very well. But I just have it hanging. So I'm just going to leave it here tonight. I have some stuff I have to do tomorrow. But we'll just come back and check it tomorrow. The temperature acclimated well. It did acclimate to the 73.9, it said. And it looks healthy. But we'll check tomorrow. Note to self, if you live in the Palm Springs area, you really can't ship live things in the summer because that thing just sat on the UPS truck all day and it could have killed it all, but hopefully it's okay.
If you remember, this all arrived and it was 91 degrees. 91 degrees in that water, but it appears though it's all survived. It's been sitting in just this blue basket for a little while. And I talked to Tyler about how to, you know, I put these in because I've never done this before, really. All I'm going to do is just cram it into rocks for now. But look, it's all super healthy. See that? Nice and red. This is the pom-pom. He said some of it's going to break off, and that's just how it is. So I'm just going to take it, try to keep it lower down, and just find a few decent spots for it, knowing that it's probably going to release at some point because there's quite a bit of flow in here. I see something, just something simple like that. And then we have the codium here, which I seriously can't believe these survived the 91. And they have little hairs on them, so it looks super healthy. See that? And all of these are going to go lower down. So let's just find a couple spots for these and just stick it in and see how it goes. This is such a learning thing for me, remember that, because I don't know anything about these. So I have no idea how this is going to work. I'm sure I'm going to have to move stuff. I'm sure a lot of this stuff is just probably going to end up blowing away because, like, there aren't really any good holes in here. See? I think this one, the codium, he said, will eventually grab on and like it'll actually grow over it. But I just, this is really hard. I just don't see any good spots to put it. Maybe we'll just put it in here. This looks like a pretty good size hole. Kind of stuff it down into there like that. I think he gave me a little bit of extra of each, but I mean, these just look really clean and really healthy. Wow, super pretty. And what is this? I don't even know what is this like white tip? Is that like a little bit of death maybe? Anyway. Just keep finding spots for it. Eventually, you guys, if you're local to Coachella Valley, we'll be able to, and you want to try this, I'll be able to give you clippings. We're going to test out the lights, too. I have a par meter that we'll put on. I just set the light schedule today, and so I'm running them at basically 100%. Evidently, Tyler has the same lights, and he says the 100% is puts out like 130 par, and this is a pretty deep tank, so I think that'll work out just fine. Maybe try one of these up a little higher. I kind of want to mix them because the red pom-pom is going to form more of like a bush, and this will get a little more stringy, the codium. I also have been testing my nitrates and my phosphates, and I have decent nitrates. It's like 10 to 14 right now. It's a little high, which is fine. I haven't changed my filter sock even once, so I just changed that, so that'll come down. But my phosphates were zero, so I dosed some neophos yesterday, and I also tested it today then. And then today it was still at zero, so I added some more neophos. I'll get it right, but I'm going to have to test daily for a little while just to make sure, you know, keep some phosphate levels up.
before I show you guys some up close, I've also been meaning to add this guy. This is just a green toadstool. And it's not going to show up very green under these lights, but it's going to be perfect for the seahorses eventually. So I'm just going to drip acclimate it real quick, and then we're going to add it. I think we'll kind of add it near the back. We'll have to wait and see where I'm going to put it. Here it is, everybody, the first livestock added after months. And this tank has been through a lot, from my error in chipping it to the Twin Star lights not fitting but working it out, the aquascape, and we have our first two kinds of macros. If you guys need macros, a big thanks to BensNems. Check them out. Tyler Inland Reef now partners with BensNems, and they didn't give these to me. I paid for them, right? But I am just so impressed with the quality of their product, and I would highly recommend it. Really great to work with as well. So check them out. I know they drop new stuff every week. They're building a huge grow out facility, so they're going to have a lot more available, because right now demand is just outstripping. Prices are good, and the clumps, the sizes they give you, are huge. So this is not a paid advertisement. They did not pay me to say this. I'm just happy with it. All I'm going to do on this tank now is test it every single day. I'm going to test for nitrates and for phosphates. And I have Neonitro and Neophos from Brightwell that I'm going to be dosing. I also have Cato Grow that I'll be dosing as well on a daily basis. As I learn about how to care for macros, I also have a PAR meter. So I'm going to test these lights just to see where they are. I have them set to a similar cycle as the other tanks, almost exactly the same, but they max out at 100%, and they're at 100% for about 7 hour photo period. The goal here is to wait about a month, see if I can be successful with these two kinds of macro, which are super easy to keep, learn the proper testing, learn how much dosing I need, and then we're going to move up to a couple different types of macro probably next month, as long as these do well. And then we'll probably do a third shipment. And then after that stabilizes, we get the nutrients in check. Then and only then are we going to add our first seahorses. So this tank should grow out really nicely. And here, we'll do like before and after pics as we go along. But anyway, big thanks, BensNems, Tyler Inland Reef. Thank you guys so much. Check them out. That's all I got for you right now.